Happy Sunday. Hello guys, welcome back to YouTube.
And yes, it's been a while, still stuck here because of COVID, probably like many others as well. So we thought we'd share some different stuff with you. And today we're gonna share
10 things
we do daily.
10 things we try to do every day. Oh, I think I would say we success do every day. Thing number one.
The first thing we do daily is meditating. We are meditating now for quite a while.
First thing we do in the morning.
First thing we do in the morning, sometimes also last thing we do before we go to bed. But this is more an optional thing. But in general, you can say at least once a day we sit down to meditate. I'm actually using a book right now where you can learn some stuff to progress and you're not just sitting and sleeping away. So this is the book that I could recommend, The Mind Illuminated.
Yeah, I started meditating probably like 4-5 years ago, and I actually started using an app on my phone. It's called One Giant Mind, and it starts very simple, just 10 minutes a day, and it's a guided meditation, at least the first 3 minutes or so. So you really like they guide you so that you know what to do at the beginning, and then you increase through different challenges to 15 minutes, 20, and then kind of free time. So that was really helpful for me.
Second point.
Thing number two. This might be a bit of an interesting one, but we scrub our tongues every morning. So this was this is a funny one. It took me a while to convince this one into getting this one, but Ayurveda says that through the night we eliminate our toxins through our tongue, or during the night our body releases toxins through our tongue. So when we wake up in the morning, most likely our tongue is probably covered in this white coated
mucus ish
toxin thing.
Somehow I always had the temptation in the morning to drink water, not because I felt thirsty, but because I felt something on my tongue. And I don't have this sensation anymore, even though it's good to drink water in the morning. I still do it, but I have the feeling I don't do it anymore because of my tongue having stuff on it.
So scrub your tongues.
Scrub your tongues.
People.
Point three.
Normally, how we do it three differently.
You did the German way, actually. Really? I think this is the more English way.
Never mind.
I don't know.
Three. I know this is fortune.
Number three. So normally we have two meals a day, and we develop the habit without any intention to fast 12 to 15 hours, because normally we have breakfast and dinner, how you call it, lunch and dinner together. For us, late lunch would be around, I don't know,
three four.
We go to bed between 9 and 10, so you had a lot of time to digest. And so the next morning, you actually, we counted, it's most of the times 12 to 15 hours where we haven't eaten. That's something that we didn't even intend to do, but it just happened with time.
Yeah, so it's more like this intermittent fasting that they call it.
Yeah.
But 2 meals a day, and we feel good.
Yeah.
And energized and drinking water.
I drink water.
Number four. We always cook fresh meals at home, especially now that everything is closed. But to be honest, it doesn't feel much different for us. So I love cooking, and I feel like I've shared my passion with Timo, and he's now quite a good chef. And
very good
sous chef,
but also a passionate trier. I like to try all the stuff, and you say try? That's probably
tester.
Yeah, tester is better.
We always try and make wholesome, delicious meals at home for the two meals we do have. Yeah, but I feel like the whole process of cooking and enjoying a homemade meal is definitely a priority for us. Number five.
We move or work out daily. So we try to do some exercises every day, or if we don't feel like exercising, we go for a big round in the park, go for a walk. If we exercise, we normally do some yoga or actually Sandra more than me does some HIIT workouts. I'm not such a big fan of that, but yeah, we do some kind of exercise every day and move our bodies every day. And I think that's really important because our bodies were designed to be moved, and nowadays we don't use it enough. So I can just say that we feel very good moving and using our bodies. And the good thing is you don't require any equipment. You just need a space where you can move a little, and then you can do your workout, get your workout in. So
number six. This is a very important one for me, or for both of us, and is that every day we try and express affection and acknowledge each other and our relationship, because I feel like we get busy, caught up in our daily routines and work, whatever, and you know, you just kind of forget to express love to each other. And so in words or just in affection, we always try to acknowledge each other and express our feelings for each other and just keep a loving, healthy relationship.
Exactly. Just a small thank you can already change the day. Like some small stuff that you maybe won't acknowledge anymore, but I think it's important to also acknowledge the little stuff and talk openly about everything.
Not taking anything for granted and always trying to treat the person you love with the love they deserve.
Number seven. We make or listen to music every day. So for me, that's a very big part of my life, and I really miss it if I can't spend some time with music. You can probably ensure them that I go crazy if I know I haven't got my workout in my practice session. So that's something we try to do every day, or on days where we don't do any music, we at least listen to music. And that's a very big and important part for us. And and I'm just so happy that we both enjoy this this thing called music, that we enjoy music. That so much, and enjoy that together.
But yeah, absolutely. I think we have the same passion and we want to create stuff together. So either we find the time to compose or work on our own music, coming soon, just individually doing our own things, but yeah, there's always music around. Okay, number seven. No,
it's
number
over.
Eight.
You're coming to
number eight. And this is, we try to practice or learn something new every day. So we both really enjoy learning or practicing a skill. Different ones or the ones that we are already obviously working on. So every day either we practice an instrument or we read about a new topic. Could be anything from health, music, psychology, food, whatever. We just enjoy it to learn. And Timo better than me, but the consistency of practicing the things you're learning. And this, I think, keeps us always learning and growing, which is a great thing.
Yeah, and I think that's so important. It doesn't matter how old you are, that you have a spark of curiosity, that you want to learn things and you're curious about things and you want to understand them, and I think that makes life so much more exciting.
Keep learning, keep growing.
Number nine, we read at least a few pages a day. So whatever book is flying around in the house, we normally get a bunch of books together and then we read through them and exchange the ones that I was interested in and exchange with the one that Sandra was interested in. And then we try to read at least 10-20 pages a day. So at least after a month or so, you're through, depending on how thick the book is, but one or one and a half books, which is better than nothing at all. So at the end of the year it sums up and then you actually know some more things.
Yeah, so normally we do not take any devices to bed, so we use this time to unwind and read every day. Which takes us to point number 10.
The last point. Sadly.
And this is, we take our sleep very seriously. We always sleep around 8 to 10 hours, or 8 to 9 hours, I would say.
Yeah, I would say at least 8 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah, 8-9.
Yeah. So we normally tend to go to bed anything between 8:30 to 9:30, and then we read, as we said, for like half an hour to an hour. So we always try to stay on point with our bedtime, and this also allows us to wake up early in the morning. But
and get stuff done.
Yeah, but sleeping is so important. This is actually one of the books I'm reading, and I would highly recommend everyone to read, which is called Why We Sleep. And yeah, I'm not gonna go into that. You can read the book, but
by Matthew Walker, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I haven't read it yet, but I know the author.
But he really goes in depth in the importance of sleeping. And to be honest, I've always being asleep, like it's not a sleepy person, but like I really need my sleep, otherwise like I really can't function, and now I know why. But definitely morning people, we like to go to bed early, wake up early, and get done. So these are 10 things that we do daily that makes us happy.
10 things we do daily every day. Thank you for watching. If you've come so far to the video, you have to give us a thumbs up, or maybe you can even subscribe to the channel. There's more interesting stuff coming.
Yeah, and if you already practice any of these things, let us know.
Which things did we miss? What do you do every day?
Yeah, should we do anything else?
Probably.
Anyway guys, see you in the next video.
Ciao, ciao.
You did looking in each other's eyes, and you can only reply with another question, and you can't repeat.
How would I know?
How old
are you?
Where did you come from?
Where do you go?